Hello, I'm Rod Lopez, Product Manager for Android Auto. And together with Jennifer Chui, a Technical Program Manager, we'll be sharing exciting new updates across Android for cars. Let's start by briefly going over our vision and commitment to automotive. Our vision of striving for a safe and seamless connected experience in every car continues to guide all of our work. And our commitment to auto has only grown in the past decade thanks to developers like you, our OEM partners, and our users. There are three experiences to help drivers no matter the car that they own. Assistant driving mode, which lives on the phone screen. Android Auto, which allows you to connect your phone to the car display. And Android Automotive OS with Google built-in, which integrates Google apps right into the car's display. We'll be focusing on the latter two experiences in today's session. We're reaching scale and continuing to grow across our products. Android Auto, which allows users to connect their phone to their car to access their favorite apps right on the display, is experiencing some real strong momentum. There are now over 150 million Android Auto compatible cars driving on roads all across the globe, with supported models from nearly every major car maker. There's also been significant growth on Android Automotive OS with Google built-in. This experience allows users to access Google Assistant, Google Maps, and apps from Google Play directly from the car display without the need for a phone. And with this deeper integration, app updates take place over the air via Google Play, allowing for continuous improvements. This experience is already available on a number of cars from top brands like Polestar, Volvo, General Motors, and Renault. And it's coming to many more soon. Now, let's jump into some updates and new experiences. For starters, Android Auto is increasingly becoming a completely wireless experience, with more and more cars supporting wireless connectivity, and the introduction of the Motorola MA1 wireless adapter. We're also continuing our efforts to make all your devices work better together with features like Fast Pair, which pairs your phone to the car with just one tap, and Digital Car Key, allowing you to unlock and start your car using just your phone. Additionally, we've been hard at work on a brand new design for Android Auto, and we're excited to be able to share it with you for the very first time. Here's a sneak peek. This new UI brings our pioneering split-screen functionality to all screen sizes and form factors. It prioritizes core user needs like navigation, podcasts, music, and audiobooks, putting them front and center, reducing the need to switch between apps to see what's playing, to favorite a song, or to find the best route. The design is adaptive and responsive, optimizing its layout for any screen and scaling perfectly to even the largest portrait and wide displays. The new design also integrates the best of Google Assistant into Android Auto, from relevant alerts to contextual suggestions that help you safely accomplish more, and they also make your drive more enjoyable. Whether it's returning a missed call, sharing arrival times with a friend, or playing recommended music, the Google Assistant can now make it happen with a tap on the screen or using your voice. Last but not least, we're introducing a set of streamlined flows to quickly message and call your favorite contacts with just one tap, and the ability to reply to messages with minimal distraction by simply selecting a suggested response on the screen. We're thrilled about this new evolution for Android Auto, and we can't wait to get it out to Android users just in time for the summer. For cars powered by Android Automotive OS with Google built-in, we're focused on bringing you helpful experiences in the car, even while parked. We previously announced that we're bringing video into the car, and we're now expanding the apps available with providers like Tubi TV, YouTube, Epix, and more. And beyond video, we'll also bring parked experiences like browsing to the car. With these additions, you'll be able to stay entertained while charging your car or waiting for a curbside pickup. Lots of exciting momentum and updates. Now, I'm going to pass it off to Jennifer to share more about how you can bring those experiences to life in the car.
Thanks, Rod. As Android for Cars platforms continue to scale and improve, drivers expect more of their favorite apps to be available in their cars. we have seen how rich app ecosystems help to create incredible user value in mobile. And we believe that similar forces will play out in TV, wearables, and automotive. And this is where you come in. Developers are a crucial part of this ecosystem that we're building in the automotive industry. We know that building experiences for cars is extremely complex, considering the variety of screen shapes, sizes, and input methods, not to mention the need to minimize driver distraction. That's why we're continuing to focus on making developing for cars as easy as possible. We introduced the Car App Library in 2020, which provides a set of templates with a simple framework for developers to build app experiences that work across both Android for Cars platforms. With the Car App Library, apps automatically adapt to different vehicle screens and even to the unique look and feel across car makers without any additional work from developers. To date, we've seen strong adoption of the Car App Library with over 200 parking, charging, and navigation apps published thus far. Without you, none of this momentum would be possible. Many of the apps published have been on Android Auto, so we're happy to share new updates to make it easier to bring these apps to Android Automotive OS. Now all developers can publish supported apps directly to production on both platforms. And we've released new design guidelines to help you along the way. Drivers of select Volvo and Polestar cars with Android Automotive OS can already experience new parking, charging, navigation apps today. And they'll be available in more cars in the near future. We've also created new templates and expanded our supported apps, adding driver apps to the navigation category like Lyft, which will be available for drivers in beta soon. And the charging and parking category will expand to include more points of interest apps like AutoPass and Fuelio to help users find locations of places they want to go. In addition to expanding supported apps, we're committed to adding new features and improvements to the Car App Library. With the release of Car App Library 1.3 later this month, we're enriching the navigation feature set to make them as useful as their mobile versions. This includes map interactivity in all map templates, content refresh to update point of interest list destinations dynamically, navigating to multiple destinations, and alerters to notify users of things like a traffic camera ahead or a new rider request for driver apps. Beyond apps that drivers can use while on the road, we're offering more experiences while parked. As Rod mentioned, we're excited to announce you'll soon be able to bring video apps to the car and browser apps at a later date. Minimal effort is required to translate your large screen tablet apps into a parked car experience, making it easier than ever to develop for and reach users in the car. Of course, when developing for cars, it's important to think about integrating voice as well. Google Assistant is deeply integrated into our new Android Auto UI, and now you can enable voice-forward interactions for your apps in the car. Please make sure to check out the Assistant and Android for Car session if you're interested in learning more. We hope you're as excited as we are about the strong momentum and updates across Android for Cars. To learn more about how to get started on all of our announcements today, from bringing apps to Android Automotive OS, to developing parked experiences like video in the car, check out our developer website at g.co/AndroidForCars. Thanks for joining, and see you on the road ahead.